Today, we are exploring the Google Authentication app pictured on the iPhone and Android phone to the left of the screen here. Authentication apps help protect your account by adding time-based second-factor codes for account access. Despite what you have read, Google Authenticator is one of the best authentication apps available. Hello everyone, this is Rick with Cybermedics. Today we are exploring Google Authentication application. We will dispel a common misconception that the app is less secure than Microsoft Authenticator. At the end, we'll demonstrate how to recover all 2FA accounts, even if your device is lost. Before we dive into the authentication app, we'll do a brief explanation of second-factor authentication. 2FA is something you know, like a PIN or a password, plus something you have, an authentication app or a hardware security key, or something you are, a retina scan, a fingerprint scan, or a facial scan. If you'd like additional details on second-factor authentication, there's a link to a video we did above. First thing we'll jump into is compatibility with the Google Authentication app. It is available on the iOS and Android operating systems. It does not work on Windows or Linux. Next, we'll talk about ease of use. It's like every other application. You say add an account, click scan QR code, take your camera, put it over the QR code, and the account is added. We're going to demo how easy this is. We'll come over to the iPhone and select add a new account. Select scan QR code. And now we're going to scan the QR code on the computer screen here. And you can see it added the Proton email account to the application. We'll go to Proton Mail and we're going to use Bitwarden to log in. Strongly recommend using a password manager similar to Bitwarden for securing your passwords. We just press Control-Shift-L, click Sign In, and because we've authenticated with the Authenticator application, it's asking us for the code. These codes are good for approximately 30 seconds, and it's really that simple. The next thing we'll explore is transferring codes. If you have your codes on one device and you decide you want to move them to another device with the Google Authentication app, that is a pretty simple process. Normally, when you add accounts to an authentication app, as you see over here, there's three accounts. You get a QR code, and you also get a text representation of that code. It's recommended that you store these in a secure location so that you could reconstitute these accounts in the future if you decided you wanted to add them back in. However, Google is unique in the way that it handles these because what it does is allows you to export either individually or in total, all of the codes you have stored on the device. So what you see on the screen here is a consolidated QR code representing all three of these accounts. We're going to come over here to the device we want to export from, and we're going to select Transfer Accounts. Now we're going to say Export Accounts here, and you can individually select which accounts you want to export. In this case, we're going to export all of them. I just want to show you the process. And now you have a QR code on the device. On the Apple iPhone, we will select add an account and we'll say scan QR code. Okay, so now all three accounts were added. So transferring codes from one device to another device is as simple as exporting the codes and then scanning the QR code from the other device, and they're instantly transferred over to the other device. Doesn't get much simpler than that. Google Authenticator is one of the simplest apps to transfer codes from to another device. Next, we'll discuss recovery. Let's assume that you lost your device. You don't have access to your codes anymore at all. There's a simple way to prepare for that so that you could completely recover on a device. It's similar to the process of transferring codes. We come in here and say export accounts. Select continue, and we're going to select all accounts, and we're going to export those. And we'll come over and we'll highlight this code and capture it. Now it's been captured to the computer, and then what you could do is click save to save this code and secure it in a secure file on your computer, encrypted, wherever you want, just save the code. Cancel out of that, come up here, we'll delete all of our accounts, Now we'll click get started. Let's assume we lost our device and we're going to say scan a QR code. And just that easy. That's how easy you can recover your accounts. You lost your devices as long as you were smart enough to export the codes and save this QR code and protect it. If you lost your devices, you would always be able to instantly get access back to all of your TOTP codes. That is the simplest method that I have seen for reactivating codes on a device. And it's one of the most secure in recovering codes because you can prepare for the inevitable that you've lost your device and you've lost all your codes. Next, we'll cover some things to know in particular about the Google Authenticator application. First one is iPhone security. One of the dings against Google Authenticator is the fact that it doesn't lock the Authenticator app. If the phone is unlocked, then someone would have access to your codes. But if you go in here to settings on the iPhone and you click privacy screen, you can turn this on. Once this is turned on, it will activate your face ID. And once that is activated, if someone is given your phone, they would have to have the phone activated again in order to get into the account. So that locks the Authenticator app. I want to show you over here on the Android phone. That does not exist. So there's more security on the Google Authenticator. It's kind of ironic. On the Google Authenticator on the iPhone than there is on the Android version of Google Authenticator. You cannot lock the application independently of the phone being unlocked. But if you're on iOS, if that's your primary method for authenticating, there is nothing better that I found on being able to use for authentication than the Google Authenticator. The next thing to know is about QR rescanning. So let's demonstrate this over here on the Android phone. We'll come in here and transfer accounts. We're going to say export accounts. We're going to export all the accounts. And we're going to scan that on the Apple iPhone. All of the accounts were added. None of them were overwritten. First thing we'll do is clean this up. And let's go through the same process with the Android phone to show you the difference. Now we're going to export from the iPhone into the Android phone. We're going to export all the accounts. So we'll come over to the Android phone now and we'll import the accounts. So under transfer accounts, it has an import function. So we'll select import and we'll say scan the QR code. You can see on the Android phone that the accounts were not duplicated. So on the QR rescan, it works better on the Android phone than it does on the iPhone. Next thing to know is about the usage ID on the Google application on the iPhone. It indicates that it does send back usage data, although it's not tied to an account. Just something you ought to be aware of. Next, we'll go into the grading of the application on all of its merits. Compatibility, I've scanned this on no less than 12 different account types, have had no problems with compatibility across the Apple or Android operating systems. Ease of use, by far and away, one of the easiest, if not the easiest, application to use. Security, ding it a little bit on the Android side because it does not have a security lock on the application, but it does on the iOS system. Transferring and recovering codes, as you saw, is so simple. As long as you remember to export to a consolidated QR code and secure that somewhere, you would never have a problem transferring or recovering your codes. And finally, there's no phone number required, unlike Authy. There's no email requirement, unlike Microsoft Authenticator, to recover your codes. So from a privacy standpoint, outstanding. So what's the overall grade? We give it an A-. If you're using it on the Apple iPhone, I would give it an A+. That's a wrap. Let us know if you have any questions or comments. Please post them below. Hope you will like and subscribe. That supports our efforts in helping others with technology, and have a great and wonderful automation day.